Hello and welcome to this LEDsupplies.com instructional video on how to cut, connect and power LED strip. We'll start by looking at how to cut LED strip down to achieve the length you need. To cut the strip, you simply need a pair of sharp scissors. Before cutting the LED strip, it's important to understand a number of key aspects relating to this product. The strip can only be cut at the points that are marked. These cut points are clearly shown by a line across the strip, as you can see here. The cutting distance for LED strip varies. In the samples we have here, you can see the cut distance is 100 millimeters for LED strips with 30 LEDs per meter, 50 millimeters for strip with 60 LEDs per meter, 25 millimeters for strip with 120 LEDs per meter, and 15 millimeters for strips with 240 LEDs per meter. Once you have found the cut line marked on the LED strip, simply use the scissors to cut directly along the line as demonstrated here. It's important to note that LED strip must only be cut at the specified marks. Cutting the strip in the wrong place will result in some of the LEDs in the cut area not working. In this example, you can see the strip has been cut incorrectly. There are two LEDs not lit. Whilst here, you can see the one that has been cut correctly is fully functional. The LED strip in this example is warm white LED strip from our selection of single colour LED strip lighting, although the same rules apply when cutting our range of colour changing RGB strip. Now let's move on to how a connection can be made to the LED strip. We supply our LED strip in lengths of 1 metre or on full 5 metre reels. For every length of LED strip you order, it will be pre-fitted with a 2.1mm input socket, as shown here. This input cable is part number C4229 should you wish to order additional units. If you need to cut down the strip, you will need to take steps yourself to be able to power it, as of course cutting the strip down may remove the pre-fitted C4229 input socket. There are two ways to make additional connections to the strip when you no longer have the pre-fitted input socket to make use of. You can either use a clip-on connector or make soldered joints. We'll look at the clip-on connectors first. These connectors come in a range of sizes to match the standard tape widths of 8mm and 10mm, as shown here, and no tools are required to fit them. Each full 5-meter reel of our LED strip is supplied with 5 of the appropriate clip-on connectors. These types of connector are not suitable for use with our ultra-high brightness series of strip due to its high power output. To use these connectors, offer the connector up to the LED strip and ensure that the red wire is aligned with the plus mark on the strip and that the black wire is aligned with the negative mark on the strip. To fit the connector, gently pull back the black locking bar. Insert the tape into the slot until it is fully located and ensure that the copper connection points are within the body of the connector. To complete the connection, push back the little black clip into its locked position by applying equal force to both sides until it meets the body of the connector. This will lock the tape into position. Gently pulling on the strip will show that it is locked into place and a good connection has been made. As you can see, the LED strip now has two wires connected to it. You can use an LED driver, which has screw terminals as input and output connectors, to add power to the strip, as we show here. Alternatively, these clip-on connectors can be used in conjunction with our part C4349 to facilitate quick powering using a standard power supply, which we will demonstrate now. You can see that order code C4349 is marked with plus and minus on its casing to indicate which way round the wires should be connected. The LED strip is also marked with a plus and minus, so make sure that the wire connected to plus on the LED strip is connected to plus on the C4349, and do the same for the minus wire. Locate the wires in the screw terminals as demonstrated and tighten up the screws. Then, to power the LED strip, simply plug the connector from the power supply into the C4349. We will now briefly look at soldering onto LED strip. Soldering is our recommended method as it provides a more secure connection. Here, we are soldering our order code C4229, the little 2.1mm input socket cable, onto a length of single colour LED strip. As before, you can now quickly power it using a standard power supply. All of our non-waterproof LED strip featured in this video comes with a sticky tape backing, as shown here. This backing can be peeled off and the LED strip can then be stuck down to an appropriate flat, clean surface. Wood, metal and plastic surfaces are generally fine. For a quality finish, you may like to consider our range of aluminium extrusion for LED strip. A selection of this is shown here. The aluminium extrusion helps to protect the strip, helps to diffuse the light, and also assists with the cool running and long life of the product. Please see the aluminium extrusion section on our website for more details. We'll now look at powering LED strip. It's important that you don't run too much LED strip as a single linear length, or the high current being drawn into the strip can cause damage. We suggest that for 4.8 watts per meter strip, a maximum run of 10 meters is powered, and for 9.6 watts per meter strip or above, a maximum of 5 meters is powered. If you do need to power more than this, then the LED strip should be wired in parallel to the PSU to avoid any damage. When selecting a power supply, we suggest allowing 20% headroom. By this, we mean if your LED strip requires 48 watts, 20% added to 48 watts is 57.6 watts. So the next largest power supply would be our 60 watt power supply. It's okay to use a power supply that can provide more than is required, but you should never use a power supply that is rated the same as your strip requires or less. To calculate how much power in watts you need, simply multiply the watts per meter of the strip by the length of strip you are powering. So if you are powering 5 meters of 4.8 watts per meter strip, just multiply 5 meters by 4.8 watts, giving you 24 watts. Then, adding the 20% headroom onto 24 watts gives you 28.8 watts. So a power supply rated at 30 watts or 40 watts would be perfect. Even a 60 watt or 90 watt power supply is acceptable, as your LED strip will only draw the power it needs from the PSU. Here we have a selection of our most popular power supplies. The SW4010E is a 12 volt 1 amp power supply, so can provide 12 watts. SW3114A is 12 volt 2 amp, so can provide 24 watts. SW4500 is 12 volt DC 3.5 amps, so 42 watts. SW3783A is 12 volt DC 5 amp, so can offer 60 watts. SW4333 is 12 volt DC 7.5 amps, so 90 watts max. That concludes this video on cutting, connecting and powering LED strip. We hope you have found it useful. Please refer to our website for other videos in the series.